David Taylor, live in State College, Pennsylvania. We're at the M2 Training Center. I'm a four-time state champion, two-time national champion, two-time Hodge Trophy Award winner, and 2018 world champion for the United States in 86 kilograms.
So my name's Dave Taylor, and I'm the father of David Taylor. And I was born in Pennsylvania, raised in Illinois, went to college in Colorado, and went into the Marine Corps after that, flew off the USS Forrestal till 1989, and then in 1990 I went to Top Gun and flew for 2 years in the Aggressor Squadron in Fallon, Nevada, and got out of the Navy as a lieutenant, stayed in the reserves for another year or so, made lieutenant commander.
I think growing up, you know, it wasn't where my dad was just, you know, constantly reminding me, you know, of the things that he had done. You know, it wasn't really like that, but it was just the values that he lived, and he based a lot of his values based on how his dad raised him and what he learned, you know, when he served for our country.
Just sort of a calling to represent the United States, and the Marine Corps seemed like the most camaraderie and the Semper Fi and all the things that you hear when you're based on the Marine Corps motto.
My dad was a do it right or don't do it all kind of guy, you know, so I learned at a young age that I'm going to do this, you know, I'm going to put 100% effort into it. I can ask him for advice on different things and he gives them to me, and but now I'm in a chance to really impact a lot of people based on the principles that I was raised for the last 28 years of my life. So, you know, people say it all the time, but I truly wouldn't be where I am without the guidance and the principles that were instilled in me a long time ago.
I was a lot tougher on him than most dads probably were. I think he sees it now that, you know, I probably was a little crazy at times, but there were also times that just being, striving to be perfect, striving to be the best, there's nothing wrong with that.
Most dads want their kids to be just great. How do we make them great? Okay, let's cut them down a weight class. Let's make them strong. Let's do a bunch of push-ups. Let's do a bunch of pull-ups. Let's make them be, but I never really had that. My dad was the opposite. He's like, all right, we're gonna go to the tournament this weekend. We're gonna actually lift before you go to the tournament, so you're tired. And then you're gonna go and wrestle up an age group or two age groups or whatever it may be, and wrestle these bigger, stronger guys constantly. So I was always being challenged. I was never really competing when I was at my absolute best, like, until I got to like the best tournaments. And then at my best tournaments, I would have great performances.
My dad was pretty hard on me, and it turned out, so I was kind of hard on him, and I saw at an early age that he had a real gift, and if he were to be like everybody else, he may never see that.
If I wasn't like Penny guy, I'd start crying. And you know, he's like, we're not doing this anymore. You know, if you're gonna act like this, then we're not gonna put the sacrifices into, and I'm 8 years old, this is the kind of conversation my dad had, you know, when I was young. If you're gonna act like this and you're gonna be a baby and you're gonna not put forth your best effort, we're not gonna go to tournaments. We'll go do something else. I'm like, no, Dad, I wanna wrestle. Okay, well then we're gonna change it up. You need to go out and start scoring points. So it's, all right, well, before you pin this guy, you need to get five different takedowns, not five of the same takedowns, five different ones. Then it was, you know, okay, we're gonna do five takedowns in three turns, and then let's score 14 points, and then you can pin him. So it was like, I was always challenged, and I loved that challenge. And I think that creativity that was instilled at a young age, not only my dad even knew what that would create long term, he just knew that was what challenged me. He knew that's what pushed my butt. I graduated college as, you know, one of the most dominant wrestlers in the sport. And that was, for me, I thought, I'll just transition right into freestyle. My goal is to be an Olympic champion. I've always said it. I'll just go do it now. Well, it was a lot more challenging than what I thought. And I think, you know, first of all, obviously having to come out and wrestle a guy at the time, Jordan Burroughs, the pound for pound best wrestler in the world, hands down. And what I really believed when I graduated in 2014 that I wasn't gonna be with him. And we had three really close matches. But you take that match aside, when I was going out and competing, I wasn't really that close to the best guys. You know, that's a tough thing. It's a tough thing as a competitor to go back and say that. I think it was just like, okay, I need to really make changes here. I need to really figure out what I want to do, or probably maybe it's time to be done wrestling.
Then all of a sudden, it was a whole new David, and being average or not being the guy has made him push in his whole life to being the best husband, the best coach, the best partner, the best everything that he can be. And in so doing, he makes us even happier now than he did then.
2017, I started having really good results, and that has, you know, led into the 2018, you know, World Championship season that I had. So I think it's just understanding, being real, being honest with your performances, being honest of where you are and where you want to get to, and what you need to do to change to get what you want. My team, my support team is my family, who I've been with for a long time, and my coaches that I've been with for 10 years. So my team is small and very impactful in what I'm doing and hoping to support, you know, obviously these big goals that I've had for a long time. And without that team, without that structure, you'll never be able to achieve what you want. There's a lot of time as a professional athlete to be productive doing other things, and I just chose to take my extra time, and I want to help people. You know, why the MT Training Center? You know, it's definitely, there's a lot that goes into it, but I really enjoy being able to help people along the process of a sport that's given me so much. I think there was always an aspect of me that wanted to coach, and I never really knew what my identity was going to be. I think the natural transition for a wrestler is to coach in college, right? And I get that question all the time. Do you want to coach in college? I don't know. I don't really know what I want to do. I do know that I love sharing my passion and knowledge with people. I think a lot of times, you know, practices are about the ego of the coach and how hard it can be, or the ego of the parent and how tough can we make our kids and do these things. And that doesn't help you long term.
It takes no time to raise your kids. It takes a lot of time to unmess them up. So that would be my goal, get them to the right place after you raised them.
My best advice to a parent would just to be encourage your son or your daughter to just make the most of their opportunities every day. Whether it's you're striving to be a state champion, striving to be a world champion, you're striving to be a state qualifier, you know, it doesn't really matter what that is, but have a goal and work towards that every day. And those principles that you're gonna learn of fighting through adversity when things are difficult and overcoming it, it means so much more, and it feels so much greater when you have something that you've worked towards and then achieving that. And then being like, okay, now what? Now what am I doing now? Oh, I'm gonna set another goal and I'm gonna go do that. So I think the more that we can encourage that type of mentality, no matter what you're doing in life, dad, coach, athlete, you're gonna just live a more full life. You're gonna feel more satisfied working towards something than just hoping someone else is gonna do it for you, because that's just not, it's not gonna happen. You're never gonna be at your best results if you're just waiting on somebody else. You gotta take some ownership. I think just setting little goals along the way is a really good way to help you achieve really big goals.
Well, first of all, you can't get hit by a train if you're not on the track. So if you're not out there doing what you love, you're never going to get what you want.
What happened is became from my dad and my coach to just my dad now. And he's my biggest fan, my biggest supporter. And we spent so much time, he knew me better than anybody.
But the most important thing is, I think, put them number one. There's no reason to bring them into the world and not make them the most important thing. So, still is the most important. My two kids are the most important things to us.
I think fighting spirit to me just means don't be willing to give up. When it gets tough, find a way. Find a way to get the job done. And I think that's something that you can apply to anything you're doing. And I think wrestling specifically, as all wrestlers, successful ones have fighting spirit.